Lord, shalom, shalom, my brothers and sisters. Welcome to the Lord's Hour. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, God, to those, hallelujah, that want to go home and be with the Lord, be with our God. For shalom and welcome. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, mighty Lord. Thank you, mighty God. I want to read this word before I go on and share anything. Praise you, Lord, in Jeremiah 42. Thank you, Lord. I want to go in there on verse 2 and on. And I want to bring a word, hallelujah, a reminder to God's people that God is still on the throne and that God is for us. Jeremiah 42:2 says, and I'm going to read verse 1, sorry. Then all the captains of the force of Jonathan, the son of Kareath, and Hesaniah, the son of Joshaniah, and all the people from the least even to the greatest came near and said unto Jeremiah the prophet, let we beseech thee, our supplication be accepted before thee, and pray for us unto the Lord thy God, even for all this remnant. We are left but a few of many, as thine eye do behold us, that the Lord thy God may show us the way wherein we may walk and the thing that we may do. Thank you, Lord. Then Jeremiah the prophet said unto them, I have heard you. Behold, I will pray unto the Lord your God according to your words, and it shall come to pass that whosoever thinks the Lord shall answer you, I will declare unto you, I will keep nothing back from you. Oh, I thank you, Lord, for your word. Then they said unto Jeremiah, the Lord be true and faithful witness between us, if we do not do even according to all the things which the Lord thy God shall send thee to us, whether it be good or whether it be evil, we will obey the voice of the Lord our God to whom we send thee, that it may be well with us when we obey the voice of the Lord our God. And it came to pass after 10 days, hallelujah, that the word of the Lord came unto Jeremiah. Then called Jonathan, the son of Kareath, and all the captain of the force that was with him, and all the people from the least even to the greatest, and said unto them, thus saith the Lord, the God of Israel, unto whom ye sent me to present your supplication before him, if ye will still abide in this land, then will I build you and not put you down. Oh, I thank you, God, for Jesus. If ye will still abide in this land, then I will build you and not put you down, and I will plant you and not plug you up. For I repent evil that I have done unto you. Oh, I thank you, God, who repent. Hallelujah. Be not afraid of the king of Babylon, of whom you are afraid. Be not afraid of him, said the Lord, for I am with you to save you and to deliver you from his hand. And I will show you mercy unto you. Let's continue to pray for mercy, that he may have mercy upon you and cause you to return to your own land. Oh, I thank you, Lord, for this land. But if ye say, we will not dwell in this land, neither obey the voice of the Lord your God, saying, now that we will go into the land of Egypt, where we shall see no word, nor hear the sound of the trumpet, nor have hunger for bread, there we will dwell. And now, therefore, hear the word of the Lord, ye remnant of Judah. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, if you wholly set your face to enter into Egypt and go into sojourn there, it shall come to pass that the sword will ye fear shall overtake you in the land of Egypt, and the famine will, therefore ye were afraid, shall follow close after you in Egypt, hallelujah, and ye shall die. Oh, I thank you, Lord, for this word. Mighty Jesus, mighty Yeshua, mighty God, that your people will receive your word tonight. That you, God, want to plant us. That you have planted us, God, in you and Christ. God, and you are not going to pull us from where you have us be. Oh, God, you have planted the USA, God, in these last days. And if they repent, you will not plant them up, God. But you, God, will have mercy on them. Mighty God, mighty Lord, almighty Jesus, in Jesus' name, mighty God, your mercy endure forever. And mercy triumph over judgment. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, God. Mighty Lord, mighty God, we had, brothers and sisters, such a, thank you, Jesus, such a great victory this past week. Hallelujah, as we have prayed for Donald Trump. First, we have spoken from the Lord that he will win months ago, many months ago. Hallelujah, all the words are recorded, brothers and sisters. And hallelujah, we have had a great victory. Praise the Lord, the word of the Lord have come to pass. I want to call into repenting those that have said that when I spoke that Donald Trump will win, they call me a false prophet on YouTube and on Facebook, and they confuse many other people. I want to call them into repentance. I want to call those people to apologize to God's people. Praise you, Lord. It is the fulfillment of the prophecy of the men of God that show who they are when they speak from God, brothers and sisters. Thank you, Lord. When I have said the word will be fulfilled, they have said it's not true, and it has confused many lives. You will not have to answer to me, but you will have to answer to God himself. Praise the Lord. On whom people you have confused and misdirected. Hundreds and thousands of followers of the Lord's Hour on Facebook has been confused as they say Hillary Clinton is winning by 95%. What Elvi said that Donald Trump will win, he is a false prophet for saying that. And I want to call those people into repentance. I want those people to apologize. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I want to call those people to apologize to God's people. All those people that brought confusion among God's people, there's been thousands of people on Facebook confused for what these people have said. Brothers and sisters, they call themselves prophet of God. They said they spoke from God that Hillary would win. There were people on Facebook, on the Lord's Hour Facebook, that said that the Lord told them that Hillary Clinton was going to win and that Elvi Zapata was a false prophet for saying that Donald Trump would win. I am calling those people to repentance. They need to repent before God. They need to apologize to God's people, especially on the Facebook page where I have more than 5,000 people, everyone knows, or most of the people knows. They have confused many of them. And if any other soul get lost, the blood will be on those that deceive them, okay, that told them lied. I am doing it for those, hallelujah, children of the Lord, those sheep. Hallelujah, they've been following the Lord's Hour, that these people went on the Lord's Hour page on Facebook to confuse them, to tell them that Hillary Clinton was going to win and that Elvi Zapata was a false prophet. It is for them. It is for them. I've been contacted about this, brothers and sisters. Some of the people, I heard them saying this, that saw their post, brothers and sisters, that saw the confusion that they created upon thousands of followers of the Lord's Hour, brothers and sisters. And for them, many have stopped listening. Many believe the lie and deceive. And I feel so sad for them. So, so sad. That is so sad. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, God. And I'm calling those people to repentance. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Brothers and sisters, the prophet Jeremiah, when he began to prophesy, hallelujah, in the land of Israel, they immediately began to call him a false prophet. But when the word of God came to pass through the mouth, came to pass through the mouth of the prophet Jeremiah, then people had no choice, including the king and all of them, to come to Jeremiah, for Jeremiah to intercede in behalf of them before God, because they have found out that when Jeremiah said to make peace with the king of Babylon, hallelujah, who was going to enter the land, they said he was a false prophet when Jeremiah prophesied from the Lord. See, this is not a word. It comes from God. Hallelujah. That the king of Babylon would enter the land, they said it was impossible. It would never happen. That Jeremiah was lying, that he was deceiving them. Brothers and sisters, when Jeremiah was speaking from God, that is so sad. That is so sad, brothers and sisters. I tell you this. I told the brothers and sisters back in 2012, I believe it's end of 2012, that I saw Jesus face to face before me. The Lord took me out in spirit, hallelujah, and praise you, God. I was sure, I believed that the Lord was coming in 2012. But only God knows the day and the hour. The Bible tells us so. And I told Jesus that I was a false prophet for expecting the Lord back in 2012. And the Lord told me that I was not. That I was not. That he was using me to prepare his children for his coming. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, God. This is why the Lord told me not to focus on they. Because when you focus on they, you will always, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, you will always mislead people. Because no one knows the day and the hour. The Bible tells us so. And that is the word of God, brothers and sisters. So we cannot tell people a day or give people a day. Praise the Lord. But when God showed me that Father's hand will be on Donald Trump to put him into office, brothers and sisters, I came on the Lord's hour, I believe it was over 3 months ago, and I told the people what would happen. And I even said, I'm not even going to give a name. Hallelujah. And some people contacted me privately and said, do you saw Donald Trump? Well, so was it him? And I said, yes, I believe it was him. Hallelujah. I saw him. God put him in the office. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, God. But again, thank you, Lord. I'm expecting people to go to the Lord, praying out God, whether the word was from God, and many other people came up and said, yes, God has shown other people the same. Praise the Lord. God began to confirm to his people, hallelujah, that Donald Trump will win, will be the president. Praise the Lord. And some people tell me, have no fear, brother. Just tell the people plainly, praise the Lord, what you saw. Praise you, God. Don't be afraid. Thank you, Jesus. And I said, well, I'm not afraid, but I do have to be careful. Praise the Lord. But I did saw it. Then the Lord took me in the tribulation and showed me Donald Trump in the tribulation, leading this nation in the tribulation. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, God. And I told the people. And I said, oh, wow, this is incredible. And I was even more afraid to say that. Praise you, Jesus. But I knew he was going to win. I know what God is going to do, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Praise you, God. I know God is going, hallelujah, to uphold this nation who has supported Israel for many years. We are still supporting Israel financially. And what a prayer, brothers and sisters. And God is going to continue to bless those who bless Israel. That is one of the greatest promises in the book of Genesis. I will bless them that bless thee. Hallelujah. God is going to bless the United States as long as the United States will continue to bless Israel, to pray for Israel, brothers and sisters, as long as the United States of America, the people in the United States stand with Israel, God will continue to bless the United States of America. Many countries, many people have said by this time, the U.S. economy should have fallen. Let me tell you what Jesus told me a few days ago. about the U.S. economy. I heard this man putting videos on Facebook, on YouTube, I'm sorry, video after video every week, 2 and 3 videos every week, that the economy of the U.S. was going to fail, brothers and sisters, hallelujah, by December of this year. And I was in a conversation with Jesus. I wanted to hear from Jesus whether that word is true. I want to hear from the Lord. And Jesus said, those words have not I said. I have not said those words, Jesus said to me. I have not said the words. The economy is going to fall. When I say, Jesus told me, it's going to fall. Oh, I thank you, Jesus. And I'm in shock. I'm with my mouth open. My goodness. I'm hearing the Lord clear. It is not going to fall in December, as this man has said. He has said it, and he stand by it. And there are many people saying that the economy of the U.S. will not pass this December 2016. Hallelujah. But Jesus told me not so. Hallelujah. But Jesus said it will fall, but the Lord said, I have not said those words. I thank you, Jesus. Just in case for those that are expecting the economy to fall in December, it's not going to happen. Thank you, Jesus. It's not going to happen because Jesus has not said so yet. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, God. Thank you, Lord. And so it's not going to fall. It is just not going to fall. Thank you, Jesus. Now, we have these different states that want to overturn the bill, the ballot for Hillary Clinton, and try to get to her. I believe she got to 235 electoral votes. I could be wrong. Someone please post them in the chat room. 235. So she will need, hallelujah, right? She needs 270 to become a president. And so with these states overturning the ballots and vote, they believe they can put Hillary Clinton in power and make her a president. So they are state gathering leaders, governors, to try to do this and try to bring this before the court, before the president. Well, the president is behind this, and Hillary Clinton, to put Hillary Clinton as a president. I was telling someone this, and we hear the news, we hear the things happening. I hear things coming out of New Jersey, in the different state. It is not going to happen. You don't need to be afraid. We can trust the Lord, brothers and sisters. We can trust the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God chose King Nebuchadnezzar. He was born one of the most horrible king, evil, fearful man, hallelujah, that I believe ever stepped foot in Babylon. He was so fearful. Every single army, 228, thank you. Every single army of the earth, brothers and sisters, fear him. Every country, every nation fear King Nebuchadnezzar. And God said to the prophet Jeremiah that he will come into the land of Israel and he will take them captive. Hallelujah. He will overcome the throne of Israel, hallelujah, and take the king and the princes captive back to Babylon and the people, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And when Jeremiah spoke these words, hallelujah, the king and the people immediately rise against Jeremiah. They could not believe that Jeremiah, being a Jew, would say such a thing, being a priest, would say such a thing, brothers and sisters. How he dare speak this way against his own nation. They thought it was an abomination what Jeremiah has spoken. Hallelujah. Because the word of the prophet can be hard, brothers and sisters, can be difficult. Many times, can be difficult to receive. And we will have people come against us and rage against us and call us for prophet and tell the people. And if the people are not listening to God, they can be confused. I am saddened for those thousands on Facebook that got confused. But they also stopped listening to the Lord's hour for months because they said if Elvi Zapata is saying that Donald Trump is going to win, he is a false prophet because Hillary Clinton is 95% right. Hallelujah. She is probably in the White House already. She's probably sitting there. And so much other thing they have said, brothers and sisters. Praise you. And they confuse these poor souls. These people that just want to seek the Lord. They just want to listen, hallelujah, to the message of the Lord and wants to grow, wants to prepare. for the coming of Jesus. Now a lot of them are confused, brothers and sisters, very confused for what these people are saying, because some of these people call themselves prophets. This is so sad. This is so sad, brothers and sisters. I'll ask you tonight to pray for them. Please help me for these. Pray for these people that are confused, brothers and sisters, that even stop listening to the Lord's Hour for what these prophets of the Lord supposedly have said, and now have brought confusion on them. And now that they have seen that Donald Trump won, they're like, wow, well, Brother Elvi was right. What he had said from the beginning was right. But now they're confused with what these other people have said. Hallelujah. This is why, since 2012, when the Lord's Hour was open, I told people January 23rd or 22nd, when the Lord's Hour was open, hallelujah, here on Black Talk Radio, I told people that everything I say that comes from the Lord to you, you must take before the Lord in prayer. You must take it in prayer. You must ask the Lord yourself. You must check with the Lord yourself. Thank you, Jesus. And many times I have asked the Lord, when you have given me a word, to please confirm it to his people. Brothers and sisters, hallelujah, I don't think that I am the best. Not so. Thank you, Lord. I only consider myself a servant of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. But I'm not going to come in here to confuse you or mislead you. I am not going to come here to do that. I can be doing something else. Praise you, Lord. And every time I said that I was misleading people, I tell the Lord, I don't want to be on the Lord's Hour. I want to close it down, Lord. That's it. I don't want to do this anymore. The Lord said, no, my son. It is I that wants you there. You are my servant. I speak through you. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. And the Lord Jesus will not allow me to quit. But I don't want to mislead anyone. I want to be raptured. I want to go to heaven. I want to be with God in eternity. Brothers and sisters, and if I mislead or lie to anyone or steal from anyone, I won't be able to enjoy that. And I want to enjoy it. I always been afraid, brothers and sisters, for my own salvation. Listen to what Matthew 18:6 says. But whosoever causes one of the little ones who believeth in me to stumble and sin by leading his way, or leading him away from my teaching, it will be better for him to have a heavy millstone, a large one, hallelujah, turned by a donkey hung around his neck, hallelujah, than to be. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. In other words, it is better to be thrown in the water with a millstone. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And this is sad. All this makes the Lord very sad. This makes the Lord very sad when people do this, brothers and sisters. Because those are the little ones who are seeking it, who are repenting, who wants to grow in the Lord, who wants to mature, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. And it's very sad because one of the brothers that faithfully every week, he is, brothers and sisters, putting this message on YouTube, Facebook, and thousands of people are listening and following this message. Hallelujah. And these people contacted him saying, Elvi Zapata is a false prophet by saying that Donald Trump is going to win. You better start continuing to promote his message because Hillary Clinton is going to win. And Elvi will be shown by everyone that he is a false prophet. Brothers and sisters, this is very sad. Have hundreds of thousands of people a week that are following these teachings. Hallelujah. I heard these people mislead them, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Wow, judgment is coming. The word becomes stumbling block and temptation to sin. And it's inevitable that stumbling block comes. But wow, to the person and whose account or to whom stumbling block comes. That is so true. That is so true. This is so sad. This is really so sad. Thank you, Jesus, that these people do this, brothers and sisters. Praise you, God. I had a guest tonight. I mean, I'm looking for a guest, a dear sister, a prophet of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I'm not sure if she'll be able to make it tonight. If not, she'll probably come on next week. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I'm gonna try to have people from different countries, Australia, Canada, and different other countries, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. We have people from France. I want to have people from Germany. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We want to have people from different countries come on the Lord Tower, because that will help the people here in America be encouraged. And even the people in the different country knows that we are the same in one spirit. I was just speaking to a minister from another country, and he was saying, Brother Elvi, I heard you speaking about judgment coming and all that on the Spanish program. And he said, you know what? This pastor told me, I was just teaching this in my church. My church, I was teaching people about this, the same that you're talking about. And I said, we're one in spirit, one Lord, one God. Thank you, Jesus. I'm so glad that pastors now are approaching, hallelujah, the Lord's Tower, ministers, hallelujah, that have listened to the Lord's Tower for years. He's been a follower almost since 2012, his pastor. Brothers and sisters, we have so much congregation from the different country, leaders, pastors, listeners of the Lord's Tower. Praise the Lord. A lot of people have moved away. But now the best-seeing prophecy come to pass. Brothers and sisters, they have realized that other people have been misleading them. Brothers and sisters. Because people will contact minister, pastor, members, and say, watch out with Elvi Zapata. He just made one of the biggest mistakes in his ministry. He just said that Donald Trump is going to win, and that's not going to happen. And so they go and put the fear on people. And people, they move away from the Lord's Tower because they say, well, if Elvi Zapata is saying that, and they're saying that Hillary Clinton is going to win by 95%, then we know he's wrong, so we better stay away from the Lord's Tower. We better see this from far. We better stop sending our offerings inside to the Lord's Tower, because Elvi Zapata just made the biggest mistake, saying that Donald Trump is going to win. And so all these people were pulling back from the different state here in the United States. Because they said, how can this be possible? She is leading 95%. The whole country is going to vote for her. How can Donald Trump win? And I told him very clear, it will be the hand of God that will make Donald Trump win. I told him very clear. You go back and hear. I told you it will be the hand of Father. Very clear, if you go back to the prophecy. It will be the hand of Father, and it was the hand of Father. Yes, Hillary must have been leading, but when God put his hand, brothers and sisters, hallelujah, when God put his hand, I was told by the Lord that God heard the prayer of his children in America. And for this reason, God was going to answer the prayer and put him into office. When everyone was suspecting all the homosexuals and lesbians and all the clinic, all the abortion and clinic hospital was suspecting Hillary Clinton. That's the favor, because abortion under Donald Trump will stop. The marriage between two men and two women will stop under Donald Trump. They didn't want to hear that. No way they want to hear that, brothers and sisters. Praise you, Lord. But see, God said that through him, he will bring justice on this land. Through him, he will bring justice. Praise the Lord. He's going to put a lot of people in jail, and a lot of people is not going to like it. But we need to pray for him. I'm telling you right now, we need to pray for him. We need to pray for Donald Trump. Hallelujah. Because he's going to put a lot of people in jail. Hallelujah. And when this happens, brothers and sisters, people will rise. People will rise, hallelujah, in such a way, hallelujah, to stop him from even going to the White House. And when he get there, it's going to be even worse, brothers and sisters. So it requires our prayer. God had answered our prayer. Now we need to continue to pray for him, brothers and sisters, hallelujah, because hallelujah, hallelujah, they're planning riots, they are planning violence, they are planning a lot. But the prayer of the righteous are very much. We already see, hallelujah, we already see this November 8th, that the prayer of the righteous avail much, that we have seen our prayer being answered, brothers and sisters. And I want to thank each and one of you here in the Lord Tower who came with us and prayed with us. I thank you very much. I thank for all of you who did not get confused, who did not believe that Hillary was going to win, who did not believe the lie, who did not believe the liars, the deceivers. Hallelujah. I thank God for you. Who believe God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. I thank for you. I thank God for you who believe God. Thank you, Jesus. Who did not let the other win, the other people, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, mislead you. Hallelujah. He'll tell you something else for you to follow. No, brothers and sisters. We are going to continue to win souls for the kingdom. Hallelujah. This program will continue, hallelujah, to win souls for the kingdom. And everything that God revealed to us, we will share. Thank you, Lord. Now, listen to this. I was taken by the Lord a couple of mornings ago, hallelujah, into the upcoming judgment over the United States. Thank you, Lord. And I'm going to ask people to pray for this nation like they have never prayed before. God is not for destroying us. That's the enemy's work. That's what the devil wants, brothers and sisters. God is not to destroy us. Hallelujah. That's why I read you Jeremiah 42. Thank you, Jesus. God says in Jeremiah, thank you, Jesus, 42:9, and said unto them, thus said the Lord, the God of Israel, unto you, unto whom ye send me to present your supplication before him, if ye will still abide in this land, then I will build you and not pull you down. I will plant you and not plow you up, for I repent of the evil that I have done unto you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God is for us, brothers and sisters. If God is for us, who will come against us? That's why I told the people, even when the prophet of the Lord said that there will be no election, that the election will be canceled, I said to the people, I know what God has said. I know that many other men and women are of God. But I tell you this, let's pray. Hallelujah. Because mercy will triumph over judgment. Whatever God has declared, if we come to him with a repenting heart, through Jesus Christ the Lord, our intercessor, our high priest, Jesus will intercede for us. Jesus will ask the Father to have mercy, to deliver us, not to bring his judgment, to repent of the word that he himself has declared in Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord. And Jesus, show me a tsunami here in New Jersey, here in the United States, the eastern part of the United States, in which I saw New Jersey, brothers and sisters, in the biggest chaos that I ever seen, brothers and sisters. The tsunami had hit our land. I was walking onto one of the main streets in the revelation of the Lord. Brothers and sisters, praise the Lord. And I saw a woman bleeding. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'm sorry for the word on her period. And I said, woman, go out to your house and wash yourself. And she said, where have you been? For a month, we haven't had no water, she said. There was a puddle of water on the street, and she was needing to wash herself, brothers and sisters. Because the store in the supermarket, she could not go by it. Hallelujah, what she needed, brothers and sisters, as a woman, for that time of the month. She could not go buy anything because all the supermarkets were empty. There was nothing available. And as the Lord even has said to his prophet, there will be no water. You cannot go even take a shower, brothers and sisters. No drinking water. The water will be contaminated. People were scared and afraid. No fear were on the land. Because millions have died, and people did not know what would happen with them. The fear that nothing was working, no electricity, no water, no food. It was very scary. It was very bad, brothers and sisters. And I believe for this reason, God had chosen Donald Trump. He will be our leader in this nation and will help the people even in the worst situation. But I believe, brother and sister, I have said that we, the bride of Christ, can still pray, can still intercede, and God can delay this judgment for the tribulation. We don't know how to see this, hallelujah, worst time that is coming upon the land. God has spoken his word from his throne. His word will now return, boys. What God has said that will happen, it will happen. But we can pray. We are still on this earth. We still got families that are not saved, that have not come to Jesus. You and I can pray for mercy over judgment. that God will repent, as he did in the time of Jeremiah. Hallelujah. God said through Jeremiah, thank you, Jesus, well, I plug you and not plug you up, for I repent of the evil that I have done unto you. As God repented for the word through the prophet, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I will answer the question later, brother. No, thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. I'm getting private question now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, God. As the word came from Nineveh to the prophet Jonah, brothers and sisters, hallelujah, that God will destroy Nineveh within 40 days. And Jonah, for a second time, praise you, Lord, word proclaiming the word of the Lord over the Ninevites, telling them that Nineveh will be destroyed. And the Ninevites heard the message of God and began to repent. Hallelujah. They began to repent for the word that they heard. And God also repent after they saw them repent. When you and I pray, when you and I intercede, when you and I call on mercy, God will hear us from heaven, brothers and sisters. God will answer us from heaven, and God will have mercy on us if we pray, if we repent. Isn't that what the Lord says in 2 Chronicles 7, hallelujah, 13? If my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from the wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sin and I will heal their land. God wants to forgive us in heaven, brothers and sisters. God wants to forgive us and God wants to heal us. God knows how much America and the world needs healing. And only him can bring it through Jesus Christ. Only God can grant us healing. But we need to pray. If my people who are called by my name, Jesus, they are Christ-like, Christian. That's what we are called. So humble and pray. One of the problems that we are having is humbling. I have called people in the past through here, through the Lord's hour, for us to humble ourselves and pray. And people don't like me always saying that we need to humble ourselves and that we need to be repenting, brothers and sisters. They think I say it too much. I'm always saying it on the Lord's hour. Thank you, Lord. I'm always saying, oh, we need to humble ourselves. We need to humble ourselves. We have so much pride in our life. They don't like me saying that we have so much pride in our life. And it's because we have. It's because the Lord has shown it to me that we do have a lot of pride. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, God. That's not Jesus said, speaking to the disciple, if ye be an evil, how do you know how to give good gifts? Hallelujah. How much your Father is in heaven if you are being evil? Hallelujah. If your son will ask you for a piece of bread, we'll not give him a serpent. He called us evil. Why? Because we are in the middle of all this evil. And all this evil on this earth has contaminated us. So how does God see us evil? He only has mercy through Jesus Christ. We are saved by grace. Saved through Jesus Christ. Saved to what he did on the cross. There's no other way. There is nothing good in us but Jesus. Brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. There's nothing good in our nature. Adam and Eve sinned in the garden. They sinned. They went into disobedience. They contaminated themselves. Hallelujah. And for you, God told Abraham, the earth will be cursed. The ground will be cursed. Everything came under the curse. Every time men break the commandment, they come under the curse. That's what humanity came under. For all have sinned. For all have sinned, says the Lord of God. We are born in sin. That's what we smell every day. That's what we see every day. That's what we hear every day. If you don't believe me that we are under sin, turn on your television. What do you hear? Bad news. Turn on the radio. What do you hear? Bad news. Turn on your computer. Turn on your computer. Hallelujah. You cannot even click on pictures, general pictures, because it will be naked woman. What is a sin? Sin, sin. Sin to your left. Sin to your right. Sin in the front. Sin in the back. Sin on top. Sin in the bottom. There's sin everywhere, brothers and sisters. That's why Jesus said, if you're being evil, know how to give good gifts. How God sees us? Evil. It's by mercy through Jesus Christ. That's why we got to be calling to repentance. And we need to be repenting every day. because we are no good without Christ. We stink because that's what sin does. Hallelujah. There was a brother whom the Lord, hallelujah, showed him how much sin stink. He was taken in the spirit by the Lord. Hallelujah. Where there was sin. And he began to smell the most stinkiest smell he had ever smelled in his life. And the Lord said to him, that is sin. I said, Lord, what? He says, Lord, what? Sin smells so bad, Lord. He says, yes, my son. That's how sin smells. Hallelujah. But the sweet blood of Jesus through repenting, the sweet blood of Jesus after the sacrifice and the cross will clean out that smell for our life. But if we're not repenting daily, we stink. Hallelujah. We stink. That's what we are. And then with all that stinkiness in our life, we call ourselves beautiful. Hallelujah. That's why we are called to repent daily. Come under the blood of Jesus, the blood of Yeshua, the blood that cleanses us from all unrighteousness, because we are full of stink by sin. Sin stinks. Hallelujah. You don't want that stinkiness in your life. There was one thing the Lord Father revealed to us. The Lord revealed to us is to ask the Lord, after we repent our sin, to cleanse our heavenly bookkeeping records in heaven, brothers and sisters. But to also cleanse with his blood after we repent our garment and our robe. How many of you remember that? We talked about this back in 2012. Thank you, Jesus. I want to remind people of things we said. Back in 2012, we shared with people what God has revealed to us. Hallelujah. And it is for you to ask the Lord after you repent, for God to cleanse all your bookkeeping records in heaven. In case you didn't know, there are bookkeeping records in heaven. The books will be open, the Bible says in the book of Revelation. Thank you, Lord. Now, also, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Your garment and your robe, thank you, Jesus. Praise you, God. Your spiritual garment, your spiritual robe, which is beautiful, which is to be cleansed by the blood of Jesus. Also, the conscience, we talked about the conscience, but the garment and the robe and the spirit. Ask the Lord to do this for you every day. After you repent, you're saying, watch how you feel much cleansed in your life and your walk with the Lord. This is very important because a lot of people are not doing this or forgot about this. To cleanse all your bookkeeping records in heaven, brothers and sisters. Your garment and your robe, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The bride, according to Revelation 19, the bride have made herself ready. Now it's you and I taking the responsibility to repenting. Don't ask God to repent for you. Don't ask Jesus to repent for you. It is the obligation of you and I, because we sin. We sin. That stinkiness will come upon us if we don't repent, and will be in your life if you don't repent. We need to repent. We need to take things serious. Sin is not a joke like some people think. Oh, I do this later. You do what? Hallelujah. Sorry to say, some people who are not repenting the sin die one way or another and then ended up in hell. The worst place anyone can live, and hallelujah, they got surprised when they opened their eyes and they're in hell, surrounded by demon, fire, and torment. What am I doing here? I knew God. I went to church on Sunday. But if you're not in daily repentance, oh my God, may God have mercy on your soul. I got to tell you the truth. Cannot come here and sugarcoat it for you. I got to tell you the truth. Hell is real. Heaven is real. But heaven, hell is real too. Not going to tell you that only heaven is real. Hell is real too. And hell is a place of torment. Not the will of God for any of us to end up in hell. Not the will of God for anyone to end up in hell. He wants us to come to heaven as children. Remember when Father says to me, I want my children, he says to me, tell my children, I want my children to come to this place, Father said. That place, beautiful heaven, with the glory of God dwells all over heaven, all over eternity. That mighty presence of God, my goodness, is so powerful and so beautiful, brothers and sisters. Praise you, God. And God says, I want my children to come to this place, hallelujah, so they can enjoy everything Father has for you and I. And he has a lot. He has endless supply. Thank you, Jesus. You're not going to run out of water up there. There's no earthquakes up there. no tsunami, no meteor. If they are, you can say hello to them. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, God. Praise you, Lord. You don't have to have, you will have no fear up in heaven as you have down here. You will have total peace under the presence of Father God. Thank you, Jesus. You will enjoy God for all eternity. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. You will enjoy his presence. I remember when I was taken before the throne, the third heaven. Hallelujah, where Father is in that third planet. I was under that glory of Father. My goodness, that goes on for all eternity. Brothers and sisters, when I saw that glory, oh God Almighty, have mercy. The first thing that came to me, I am not worthy. It's only by Jesus. You get a clear understanding when you go to heaven that it's only by Jesus that you make it in. Thank you, Lord. And I was there with my mouth open. One of the holy, holy angel of God that dwell in this place. I just saw the angel, and I saw the glory of God. And I said, oh, my goodness. I could not close my mouth with such a glory of God, endless glory of God. It was incredible, brothers and sisters. I wish I can describe it to you. I have said, brothers and sisters, that the word of God, hallelujah, do a fair job describing God. God is so great. He is so awesome, infinite, brothers and sisters. I cannot describe you in human words how great God is. But I was standing in that glory, looking at that glory of God. Thank you, Jesus. And one of the angels came and touched me on the shoulder and said, sing to him. Thank you, Lord. Because I could not. The angel touched me on my shoulder and said, and I began to sing, brothers and sisters, hallelujah. Before I even thought of what song to sing to God, I began to sing to Father. And the Holy Spirit, brothers and sisters, through my own mouth, brought forward the most beautiful song I ever heard. I have heard even song from heaven. Hallelujah. And I know the people down here that God gives them, hallelujah, music. Brothers and sisters. But I began to sing in heaven for Father. The most beautiful song I ever heard coming out of my mouth. Praise you, Lord. I'm terrible in singing. I tell you the truth. I'm honest. Hallelujah. I don't know how good am I as a preacher, but I'm terrible in singing. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, God. And the most beautiful song came out of my mouth. The Holy Spirit took hold of my mouth, and just the music came out. Tremendously beautiful for God. My goodness. Praise you, God. But the glory of Father was so strong. Hallelujah. The glory of Father was so strong, I could not even move. I was like paralyzed under that glory. And it wasn't that I could not even move. And that it was too awesome. I just wanted to enjoy it for eternity. I just wanted to be there. I didn't want nobody to bother me. I think even the angel tapping me on the shoulder to sing to God was bothering me already. Leave me alone. I just want to enjoy this glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Praise you. I'm looking at that glory. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Isaiah 6 says, hallelujah. That the seraphim sing and says, hallelujah. They sing to God. Hallelujah. Let me look it up real quick. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, God. Praise you, God. They cry out. And one cry out to another said, holy, holy. Holy is the Lord of hosts, and the whole earth is full of his glory. Hallelujah. And the pulse of the door moved, and the voice of him that cried, and the house was filled with smoke. Thank you, Jesus. And just, hallelujah, just like Isaiah, then Isaiah said, hallelujah unto me, for I am undone, because I am a man unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of the people unclean lips, for my eye hath seen the King. Hallelujah, the Lord of hosts. You see, once you go to heaven, you immediately begin to realize where you've been. I looked at earth from heaven at one time. Jesus allowed me to do this. I looked down to earth from heaven. And let me tell you what I looked. I saw the most pitch black I ever seen in my life. brothers and sisters, looking at earth from heaven is looking at our hell from earth. Some people have been taken to hell. I've been taken to hell. People know what I'm talking about. If you've ever been taken to hell, it is pitch black unless you get close to the fire. But it's pitch black as you go down the tunnel to hell. But it is the same when you look at earth from heaven. It's pitch black. I mean, I don't even know how we live down in this pitch black, brothers and sisters. When Jesus said, ye are the light of the world, hallelujah, he is right. He is right. This earth has no light in the spirit. It is pitch black. Thank you, Jesus. It is pitch black. Without Christ, there is no light down here. You cannot see where you're going. Praise the Lord. Only the bride of Christ can see where she's going or where she wants to go to heaven. Thank you, Jesus. That's why the bride of Christ can preach, share the gospel. Praise the Lord, because she knows where she's going. She knows where she's walking. Thank you, Lord. But if you don't have Jesus in your heart, if you don't have Jesus in your life, you need to repent and receive Jesus as your personal Savior and say, Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. Please forgive my sin. I believe you died for me on the cross and was raised on the third day. Please, Lord, I make you Jesus Lord of my life. I receive you, Jesus, as my personal Savior. Come and live in my life, Lord, and then let your light shine through me. Oh, I thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We've been called out of darkness. Because this earth is completely darkness. I saw this from heaven, and I was stunned. When I saw this, let me tell you what happened after I saw it. Lord, I don't want to go down there. I don't want to go down there anymore, Lord. But the Lord has a plan with my life. And he says, he has chosen me to preach his word. Hallelujah. And so for this I have been chosen, says the Lord. Or I've been born. This is for this you have been born, my son. I had complaints to him like, what is it, what, 2-3 times he has told me to say, for this you have been born, to preach his word. Praise you, Lord. But I'm not worthy, brothers and sisters. I am not worthy. I don't call myself a prophet. I don't call myself a preacher. I don't call myself a pastor. What are you? A servant. That's it. A servant. I tell people, call me your brother in the Lord. It's not just call me a servant of the Lord. That's it. I don't want no title. Praise you, Lord. I want no glory to go to Jesus. Brothers and sisters, what Jesus did on the cross, no one will ever die. Praise the Lord. But it's because of the love of Father. For God so God loved the world, brothers and sisters, that he had given his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes he should not perish, but have everlasting life. God wants us to have with him an eternity next to him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I've been taken to eternity. I questioned God so much, I remember doing this a lot. The God took me through eternity to show me that he's going to bring me there. The last time I was taken to the garden of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, where they are mighty archangels, or sheriff, I'm sorry, and angels and spirits, and hallelujah, mighty God was there. I cannot see it because God dwells with an invisible light, the Bible says. But Jesus was there standing next to me. I'm looking at Jesus. I cannot stop looking at his beauty. He is so beautiful. Thank you, Father, for Jesus. The Holy Spirit was there. Thank you, God, for your Holy Spirit. He is so awesome. I'm still repenting if I have offended the Holy Spirit. Praise you, Lord. Because anything sinful in our life will offend the Holy Spirit. Any sexual sin, any black magic, any type of magic, white, yellow, blue, purple magic, hallelujah, golden magic, silver magic, whatever people call it magic this day. Hallelujah. I heard up the other day, I think it was blue magic. They had changed the name of magic. It used to be black, white, and yellow, I believe it was. And, hallelujah. But now they got blue magic, purple magic, green magic, golden magic. The devil keep coming up with stuff, getting people in trouble with God, brothers and sisters. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, God. Praise you, Jesus. All that garbage in our life will offend the Holy Spirit. And I ask the Lord, Lord, what offend your Holy Spirit? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. So we have to be careful. He is holy. That's why the Bible says Holy Spirit. I don't like to say Holy Spirit a lot. You know that I have said this many times on the Lord's Hour. I hear people saying, the Holy Spirit said this and that. I am so careful with that. I really am. Hallelujah. One, because of blaspheme against God's Holy Spirit will not be forgiven. That's one of the things. And when Jesus was preaching, hallelujah, they said that when he was speaking from Beelzebub, they began to judge Jesus for what he was saying. And Jesus warned them of the blaspheming of the Holy Spirit. A lot of people, they know how serious this sin is. They don't realize. They don't realize, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. But a lot of believe people, when they stay in the tribulation, they probably would want to be beheaded. But if they have blasphemed the Holy Spirit, even if they are beheaded, they will quickly into hell. That's where they're going. They will not go to heaven. Blaspheming the Holy Spirit will have no forgiveness. That's the unpardonable sin. So we have to tell people about it, and we have to tell people to be careful. The Holy Spirit is such a beautiful God, such a beautiful person of God. The Spirit of God, he is. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I praise you, God. And so the Lord was there, and I'm looking at the Lord. Jesus says, my son, you will be in this place. Thank you, Lord. Sometimes he'll call me his son. Sometimes he'll call me his servant. Father says, my son, you will be in this place. Praise the Lord. His beautiful voice came out. I love it when Father talks to me. I love it when Jesus talks to me, but I love it also when Father talks to me. My goodness. When Father talks to you, what comes to you is that you immediately will know that he is your Father. You will truly will know that he is your true Father. Now, yes, we call people on earth Father or Mother. But when Father talks to you, the creator of you and I, when he talks to you, and he calls you my son or my daughter, you will immediately know that this is the Father, that you only have him as a Father, and that he is your true Father, your true Father. You and I are here because he willed us to be born. It was his will for us to be born in this time. He had chosen us to be born in this time, to serve him in this time that you and I are in. You may be asking yourself, why in this last day? Why am I being born in the last day? Why am I serving God? Why is it so hard for me to serve God in the last day? Because Father had chosen us to serve him in this last day. He wanted him to do this. And he thought about all these things before he created the earth, brothers and sisters. Because we've been in his heart and in his mind, brothers and sisters. That's why. And all his plan, brothers and sisters, all his creation, he finished in the beginning. In Genesis chapter 1 and chapter 2, God in chapter 2 of Genesis, he finished all his work. When he got there, you said, but Brother Elvi, that was the beginning. God finished all the work there in the beginning. Why? Because he spoke all the word. All God needs to do is speak the word, and it's done. It's done. It could take years for the word to come to pass. So what? It's going to happen no matter what. No devil, no fallen angel can ever, they can never stop his word ever. They can try it, but they cannot. They cannot, brothers and sisters. See, the generations of Noah, when Noah God destroyed the word, the world through Noah, or in the time of Noah, brothers and sisters, God preserved Noah and his family. Because Noah feared God. Noah found grace. We have found grace before God through Jesus Christ, brothers and sisters. We have found grace. By grace we are saved in these last days. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Next week, brothers and sisters, I want to say this. I'm going to New Jersey. 2 days ago, or 2 mornings ago, the Lord showed me the tsunami. It's going ahead by land. I fear that I will be there when the tsunami would hit. I don't know when it's going to hit. I want to make it clear. I don't know when the tsunami is going to hit in the eastern part of the United States. But it's soon. It is very soon. And the Lord showed me the destruction that would happen. And I fear, and I said, Lord, I went to prayer before the Lord a couple of days after speaking with some of my brothers and sisters. And I said, Lord, will you God delayed the tsunami, that it will not happen while I'm in New Jersey a week with my family here. My mother, my brothers are waiting for me. And I said, you will please, will you please? And I will do the Lord's Hour from there too. Praise the Lord. And I said, will you please, Lord? And the Lord says, because you have asked this, my son. Hallelujah. It will be done. Thank you, Lord. I felt so favor. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. No, the rapture had not been postponed. The day and the hour, no one knows. But God does everything in his time and in his season. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. No, the rapture had not been postponed. It is that only Father knows the day and the hour. Everything that we see happen, brothers and sisters, God had made his decision a long time ago. Remember that we are in the past. God is in our future. Jesus is our future, brothers and sisters. Don't you ever think that God is going to forget about us. Never. He will never forget about us, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. We are ever present before the Lord. God loves us every day. We are in his mind and heart every day, brothers and sisters. God will never leave us. God will never forget about us, brothers. Never, never. Someone gave me a word. As I was nervous for the tsunami coming, hallelujah, I know we're going home soon. Someone gave me a word. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, God. Thank you, Lord. Isaiah 43. This is what God says to us. Hallelujah. 14, thus said the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, for your sake, having sent to Babylon, and have brought down all their nobles, and the Chaldeans who cried in the ship. I am the Lord, your Holy One, the Creator of Israel, your King. Hallelujah. Your King. God is our King, brothers and sisters. God is our King. Remember that. He is our Commander in Chief, and He is our King. He is the head of all. He is ahead of all of us. Thank you, Lord. Thus said the Lord, who made a way in the sea, a path in the mighty waters, brothers and sisters. God has a plan for those that will be alive after the tsunami in New Jersey. It might be that God will use some of his people to help other people. Whatever plan God has for your life, continue to pray and continue to repent. Verse 17. Who bring forth the chariot and the horse, the army and the power. They should lie down together. They should not rise. They are in a stink. They are quenched as a toll. Remember, ye now the former thing. Neither consider the things of old. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Remember, ye now the former thing. Neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. This you know, I will even make it a way in the wilderness, in the river, and in the desert, brothers and sisters. God is going to make a way for each and one of us. He is our provider. He is our creator. He is a maker. He is going to make a way for you and I. You don't need to fear. You don't need to be afraid. God wants us to trust him more every day. How do we show God that we are trusting him? By fasting, by praying, by being in the word, by coming close to him. The more you pray, the more you come close to God, the more, hallelujah, God will work in your life and prepare your heart and your life for what is coming. Because he is preparing us. I don't know if you noticed, but the Lord has been preparing you and I, hallelujah, for the worst things that are coming, brothers and sisters. Yes. He's going to take us out of here very soon. He has said through his servant that any day with the bride, he's going to take out, brothers and sisters. The beasts of the field shall honor me, the dragon, the owl, because I give water in the wilderness, in the rivers, in the desert to give drink to my people, my children. If you are afraid that you ain't that might, like one of those animals that die in the wilderness, or one of those that you think that has no value, God says the beast of the field shall honor me. Whatever's left in the United States after the tsunamis and earthquakes, if you are still serving the Lord and firm, all those things that you would think that are left, that are that worth nothing, they honor the Lord. The beast of the field shall honor me. The dragon and the owl, because I give water in the wilderness and the rivers and the desert to give drink to my people. God's people will always have water from God. Jesus told me back in New Jersey, back in Massachusetts, before I came to North Carolina, I remember. Jesus took me out in the spirit and took me to New Jersey. Before I moved or made a move, I was very afraid. And I kept going to the Lord and seeking the Lord about it, making sure that I was being led by the Lord, by God, and not by my own mind, my own thinking, my own emotion, what I wanted. Not my life, nonsense. I just wanted the word of the Lord in my life. And Jesus took me out in the spirit and took me to New Jersey. I saw the tsunami coming into New Jersey. The tsunami pounded many homes and many buildings. And the house that I was staying, hallelujah, the water only came to the front of the door. They're not even past where I was. My family and I, my children, was well kept by God. And Jesus said to me in that revelation, I will keep you and your family. Do not be afraid, my servant. I will protect you and your family, and you will not be harmed. But I will keep my protection over you. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, God. Praise you, Jesus. I only trust the Lord, brothers and sisters. I don't trust myself. I do not trust myself. Hallelujah. I don't trust men either. I only trust Jesus Christ. A lot of people got hurt and offended for what this that I said, but I keep repeating it years after years. I do not trust myself. I do not trust men, but I only trust Jesus. It don't mean that I don't love my brothers and sisters. I do. I do, and I pray for them every day. But I only trust Jesus. I can deceive. People can deceive, but Jesus will not deceive anyone. That's why I only trust him, brothers and sisters. Only Jesus. Only the Lord. And I encourage you to do the same. Only trust Jesus. And always seek the Lord about everything. Pray to the Lord. Pray to the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Always ask the Lord for guidance and confirmation. These people have I formed for myself. They should show forth my praise. You see, brothers and sisters, you and I were called, were made, were formed by God to praise him. That's why the angel taught me on the children and say, praise him, sing to him. Because that's what we are made, we are formed. I'm going to read it again. Isaiah 43:21. This people, that's you and I, this is you and I, take this word to heart. This people have I formed. What did he form us? In the womb of our mother. In the womb of our mother, according to Psalms. This people have I formed for myself. Thank you, Jesus. They should show forward my praise. Don't hesitate to praise the Lord. No matter what situation you're going through, right there in your living room, in your bathroom, in your closet, begin to raise your hand and praise the Lord. God seek a worshiper that worship him in spirit and in truth. Worship your Father in heaven. Father God loves our worship. Don't hesitate. Don't say, Brother Elvi, I cannot pay my bills. Brother Elvi, I lost my job. Praise him. Praise him. Brother Elvi, you don't understand. My marriage is terrible. Praise him. Brother Elvi, my family, we're all divided. Praise him. Praise him. Oh, my God. Oh, my Jesus. Brother Elvi, my health is not good. Praise him. Praise him. Raise your hand and close your eyes and praise him. Praise him. Brother Elvi, my children don't listen to me. Praise him. Praise him. Brother Elvi, you don't understand the sickness that I have in my body. Praise him. Brother Elvi, financially I'm struggling. Praise him, my sister. Praise him, my brother. Praise him. Father, seek worshiper who worship him in spirit and in truth. And those worship must worship, Jesus said. Must. You know what a must is? You and I must worship him. Why? Because it pleases Father. He comes to be one with you through praise, brothers and sisters. Your praise, our praise, come to the throne. We must, God demands that we must worship him. this people highlight for myself, they should show forward my praise. God wants your praise to come forward from you, from your heart, from your life right before his throne. Thank you, Jesus. Let me share this with you tonight, this beautiful revelation. When you and I pray, Jesus take up our prayer before God. The angels take our prayer before God. Now, who takes our praise before God? Who takes up our praise before God? Our praise goes before him, brothers and sisters, through Christ. Our praise has no barrier, brothers and sisters. There's no war on hell. There is no war on earth. There's no war in the air. There is no demon that can stop our praise. They can stop. They can hinder our prayer, but not our praise, brothers and sisters. You want demon to leave your house, to leave your family, to live your life. Begin to praise God. Begin to praise the Lord. Your prayer, hallelujah. When it comes up, brothers and sisters, no demon can stop your praise. They can hinder your prayer. We got that in the Word. But not your praise. Pure praise is so powerful that it cannot be stopped. Praise. God seeketh worshiper. Hallelujah. Prayer, there are many prayers. There are many that pray. There are few worshipers, brothers and sisters, true worshipers. Those are worshiping in spirit and in truth. There are very few of them. And God is still seeking for them because there's so few. I thank you, Lord. Verse 22. But thou hast not called upon me, O Jacob. But thou hast been weary of me, O Israel. See, this is what God is saying to us. You are so worried. You are so concerned, but you're not coming to me. God is saying to Israel. God is saying to us. You see, this is the thing with people. They're worried. They're concerned. A lot of people were worried that Hillary may win. What do you do about it? Do you pray that Donald Trump will win? Or you just was worried? Concern was consuming you, brothers and sisters. Instead of sounding the trumpet that Donald Trump will win, we sound the trumpet and we pray. Brothers and sisters, that Donald Trump will win, and God, hallelujah, heard our prayer and answer our prayer, brothers and sisters. I thank you, Lord. That's what we do. We take our prayer before the throne. Hallelujah. And you just don't do it once. You just don't do it twice. You just don't do it 100 times or 1,000 times. You keep doing it. You keep doing it. You keep going before the throne. God, please. And don't worry about begging the Lord. I beg the Lord. I said, Lord, I beg of you, please, Lord, have mercy. Oh, please, Lord, beg him. Ask him. Please. Hallelujah. Seek of him. Thank you, Lord, because he will have mercy. As he had mercy on Jacob, he will have it on you and I. I thank you, Lord. Thou hast not brought me the lamb or kiss of the burnt offering, neither have honored me with thy sacrifice, and have not caused thee to serve with an offering, hallelujah, nor weary these with incense. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Verse 25, I and he that blotted out thy transgression for my own sake, I will not remember thy sin. God will not remember our sin. God will forgive us if we repent of it, brothers and sisters, for his own sake. Why? Because he sent his son to die on the cross. His son shed his blood. His son gave his life, brothers and sisters, on the cross. And when he shed his blood, life was in the blood. He shed a lot of blood was pouring down, brothers and sisters, down from his body. Abundant life for you and I was coming out of the cross, was coming down him. And then water, representing of the Spirit. We got blood, forgiveness of sin, and we got water, the Spirit. When they opened his eyes, water and blood came out. Spirit was there. God was there. The Holy One of Israel was there. Hallelujah. And God said through Christ to us, God says to us through Christ, I, even I am he that blotted out thy transgression for my own sake. I will not remember thy sin, God says to us through Christ. God don't remember. That's why he called us a daily repentance, because he doesn't want to remember our sin. And if we are repenting our sin, the blood of Jesus cleanses us, there's no sin. There is no sin. Confess your sin. Repent your sin before the Lord. Ask him for his mercy that endures forever. Brothers and sisters, I said this many years ago, and I will say it again. As long as I am in this world, I will continue to pray for mercy. Even if I'm shown that the United States will have judgment tomorrow or tonight, I will not stop praying for mercy, that the judgment will be put into the tribulation. I know we will see judgment before we go home. I know that. Jesus told me that. I told people back in 2010 in a video that when Jesus came to me, Jesus said, Jesus showed me tsunami and earthquake coming. He showed me the tsunami to the United States and the earthquake to California. I remember Jesus was showing me the earthquake to California. And I said to Jesus in the revelation of the Lord and the Spirit, I said, Lord, yes, but that is for the tribulation. And Jesus said to me, that's for many things. Hallelujah. I quoted the Bible to Jesus. I stand on the word, brothers and sisters. I stand on the word of God, which is Jesus Christ also. Thank you, Lord. And the Lord Jesus said, yes, but you will see judgment. And to me, that was new. I mean, I know what a lot of people are saying, Brother Elvi, that's for the tribulation. Dear brother, dear sister, I got to tell you that Jesus told me to my face that before we go home, we will see judgment, brothers and sisters. Thank you, Jesus. We will see judgment before we go home. A lot of people want to go home and see no judgment. I only tell you this because Jesus himself told this to my face. Because I used to believe, I used to be a believer, and from my church teaching, that the judgment was for those staying in the tribulation, that we will go home, the bride of Christ, and the rapture, the departure, and that we, brothers and sisters, was not going to see that. That's what I believe. But when I have the King of Kings and the Lord our Lord right before me in that revelation of the Lord, and said that we will see judgment before we go home, he showed me the judgment in California. I remember watching the television, I believe it was CNN. Jesus was standing right there with me. And then in another revelation, he took me to New York, showed me the tsunami. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And I wonder why. I always wanted to know for a little why. And then Jesus showed me in another dream that the reason why he's bringing judgment before the bride comes home is to wake up the sleeping believer, the sleeping bride. He showed it to me very clear. Help me to understand, because I didn't understand why. Again, I quoted the Bible to Jesus. I stand on the word. It's what I believe when I came to the Lord many years ago. Praise you, God. And my pastor, the leaders always say, always stand on the Bible. You'll never be wrong if you stand on the word. So when I saw Jesus face to face, I quoted the word to him. But the Lord says, yes, that's for many things, but they will see judgment. Why? Because the bride needs to be awakened. Those that are backsliding, Jesus showed me. There are many backsliding. He showed me that there will be. At this last day, that was years ago, brothers, it was 5 or 6 years ago or more. Jesus showed me that in this last day, before the rapture, before the trumpet sound, Jesus showed me, there will be many Christians sleeping and backsliding. And he showed them to me. In that revelation, Jesus showed me these thousands upon thousands upon thousands of Christians sleeping. People are walking the fire in the presence of the Holy Spirit. We're now in the last day sleeping, backsliding, back into the sin of the world, practicing sin like everybody else, like the drunkard in the corner, like the prostitute in the corner. They will be doing the same thing. Even though they knew the word, they knew the Lord, but now they will be backsliding. And when the judgment hit, I remember when the judgment hit. Hallelujah. That's why I can't hear people, the 3 days of darkness, that's what I saw. True back then. But in the last day, there will be the darkness day that will come. Brothers and sisters, and right before the darkness, the 3 days of darkness, that tsunami that came to Florida, I saw it, brothers and sisters. I was like, oh my God. It was such a great, large tsunami that, brothers and sisters, by that time, I was up north of Massachusetts, close to New Hampshire, brothers and sisters, close to what you call Plaston, New Hampshire. Haverhill was the city. And, brothers and sisters, the tsunami came to Florida, hit all the state coming up, New Jersey, New York, Connecticut. And when I spoke this word back then, there were people from Connecticut that contacted me that said, we have had this dream, Brother Elvi. What the Lord has shown you, we have seen also. And then began people from New York, New Jersey, and around the country contacting me up in Massachusetts. People were contacting me, email. Every way people could contact me, they were just contacting me from the different places. And people sending me their phone number, call this phone number, Brother Elvi. We want to talk to you. We've seen, the Lord has shown us what you see. And then also other people telling me, the Lord has confirmed that what you're saying is from God also. Contact me, pastor, leaders, people from different churches and different denominations and country, brothers and sisters. Begin to contact me, telling me, Brother Elvi, what you're saying from God is from God. It's true. God has confirmed it. God has revealed it. We know it from God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Other people got angry. How dare you talk about these things this way? Who are you? Are you a prophet? What church did you come from? Some people got really, really angry. A lot of people don't want to hear about judgment. Oh, no, they want to go to heaven in a cloud, laying back, eating and drinking, enjoying themselves. Well, praise God. We need to repent. We need to seek the Lord. Praise you, God. The Muslims, before they kill themselves, they're waiting for wives that they're going to get. People always want the good thing before anything happens. God would have mercy if we repent and if we seek the Lord. Praise you, God. We got to stop flying in the cloud like the Muslim before they kill themselves, thinking of all this bride they're going to get. The devil loves to deceive and mislead people. He's been doing it for thousands of years. It works. Why would he change it? It works. People fall into the same lie all the time, into the same lying dreams. No judgment, no judgment. They're going to see judgment like they've never seen before. United States have not seen judgment ever until this tsunami that is coming. Millions of life at stake, brothers and sisters. But see, God is merciful. We were praying for mercy. Praying for mercy, brothers and sisters. He's been having mercy because he's a merciful God. I'm not the only one that God has showed us here in the United States. God, years ago, over 20 years ago, had raised prophets, 50, 60 years ago and more, all over the United States to talk about this judgment that will come. A lot of these prophets have already died. People don't even remember it, brothers and sisters. Men and women of God that God had raised and showed them the judgment, brothers and sisters. But what was the first thing they prayed was for mercy. And they kept fasting and praying for mercy for America. And what did God do? God repented in the year he spoke about the judgment and kept the lady. And Jesus kept going to the Father, Father, have mercy. Father, have mercy. Father, have mercy of America, of my people in America, Father. Please have mercy. And calling on mercy upon the throne. Have mercy, Father. Father, please delay it. One more year, Father. Father, one more year. Not this year, Father. Oh, my son, 2010. No, no, Father. 2008, my son. No, 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 Father. Father, no. Father, hallelujah. 1990. No, no. 1992. No, no, my son. No, no, no. No, Father, please. Mercy, Father. Mercy, mercy. Okay, my son, other lady. 2006. No, no. Father, please. One more year, Father. More mercy. Look, more people are repenting, Father. They're repenting. 2012, God said, we'll bring the judgment. Jesus kept going to the Father. Father, please have mercy. Father, there will be people repenting. And there was a great multitude to our thousands in Boston, Massachusetts, California, and around the U.S. that were calling up on mercy. God raised people in New York City, pastors and leaders and churches. And there were pastors and churches writing to me. Brother Elvi, churches from Houston, from Texas, from different states, contacting me. We are in prayer with you, Brother Elvi. Churches in New York. Pastors, alive churches in New York, we are in prayer with you, Brother Elvi, for mercy. Hallelujah, that the judgment will not come. in 2012. I mean, I never heard from so many thousands of church members and church leaders contacting me. No, we are praying for mercy. We are praying for mercy. Thank you, Lord. I remember, hallelujah, a group of people, hallelujah, in that building, the Lakers building in, hallelujah, in California. People got together in 2012 to pray for mercy for America. Thank you, Jesus. And God, again, heard the crying, hallelujah, of his people over America. And granted more mercy. Granted more years, brothers and sisters. Do that delay the rapture? No. Rapture day, God, Father knows. That will not delay the rapture. God knows the day. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. A lot of us were not ready in the 90s or in the 80s. Imagine if God would have destroyed America in the 80s. Hallelujah. How many of us would have been lost? How many of our lives would have been lost? Think about that. Hallelujah. You and I were not ready in the 80s. Probably not ready in the 90s. A lot of people that come to the Lord maybe 10, 50 years ago, hallelujah, verses were not ready. They were not ready. They were simply not ready. But Jesus knew this. You see, this is why you cannot be worried. You cannot be concerned. You got to trust the Lord. He knows who is ready, who is going to come to him. He knows them by name. He knows them. This is why we pray for mercy. I have people tell me this year, don't pray for mercy on me. It's too late for America. There will be no election. They told me, they wrote to me, they spoke to me. Don't pray for the election, brother. There will be no election. There will be no candidate winning. The election will be canceled, they said. But that didn't stop me. I went to the Lord. Lord, the Lord says, pray for the election. Pray, the Lord says. Thank you, Jesus. And there's the mercy of God one more time. Again and again, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Jesus came to say, not to condemn. And as long as we have the Lord at the right hand of the Father, we can cry out for mercy. And we will continue, brothers and sisters. Until the day I am raptured, I am going to pray for mercy. When I'm raptured and I'm in heaven, and I'm told heaven I cannot do no more, then I will not do no more. But as long as I am down here on this earth, and God allow me to pray for this nation and for the world for mercy, I told the people a couple of years ago, when that typhoon hit the Philippines and killed those people, I was in prayer with the Lord, I remember. It had not even crossed my mind to pray that typhoon would dissipate, be nothing. And Jesus spoke to me after I heard the news of the people that died. And Jesus said, that would not happen if my people were to pray. I was shaking from the top of my head to the bottom of my feet. I did not know that we can pray and this typhoon or whatever will disappear. Tsunami, earthquake, whatever, will disappear. Hallelujah. That was not taught to me in my church. A lot of the things the Lord has been revealing it to me directly to teach me. I mean, I'm learning. I'm still learning. I'm still learning from the Lord. I don't know. But I know the one who knows all, Jesus Christ. And the Lord said, that would not happen if my people would have prayed. My people would have prayed, that would have not happened. We ignore the power of prayer. That the prayer of the righteous availeth much. We ignore this, that with God, all things are possible. All things are possible, Jesus said, to them that believe. All things are possible with God. Thank you, Jesus. Faith can move the mountain. We need to learn to pray. We need to learn to cry out. And praying is actually being humble, humility. Not praying, being selfish and prideful. Brothers and sisters, we got to stop being prideful. We need to humble ourselves and pray. That's what God says. If my people who are called by my name humble myself and pray, first in humility. Why don't people pray? Pride. Why don't people pray for the nation? Pride. Why don't people pray that God would have mercy and not bring the judgment before we go home? Pride. When we see a hurricane coming and you don't pray and we don't repent, rebuke it and pray for it to dissipate, What is a prayer? When people are sick and they're requesting prayer and we don't pray, that is prayer. Oh, if we only knew how prideful we are. It stinks. We're so prideful it can choke a human being, can choke a baby. The pride that we have in us can choke a baby. We are so prideful. We need to repent pride, brothers and sisters. We need to repent pride, brothers and sisters. We truly do. The whole multitude in the times of Noah did not listen to God through Noah, the prophet. But the animals, they all heard God. They all wanted to come into the ark. When God calls the animal, they all came by a pair. Some seven times. They all came walking humble, quiet. No roar from the lion. No roar from the lion. Quietly, he came to the ark. Why do animals can listen to God? And human can turn their head away and harden their heart not to listen. Pride. There's no pride in animals. It's only pride in human. That's what keeps us from receiving the blessing, from being a blessing to other people, pride. A lot of people just want to go home and say to themselves, pride. That is pride. They think it's humility. Oh, Brother Elvi, I just want to go home. Pride. Because if God wants to use you to say multitude, be humble and say, yes, Father, here I am, send me. It's not what the prophet said. Here I am, Lord. Here I am, Lord. Send me, said Jesus. Here I am, sent me, said through Isaiah. I said, here I am, sent me. Why are you saying to God, here I am, God, use me. Use me, Father. What do you want me to do? Pray for the nation, pray for the people. Here I am. I'm going to begin tomorrow morning. I'm going to begin tomorrow. I'll begin tonight, Father. I'll do what you want me to do. You want me to intercede for the nation. You want me to pray for mercy for America. You want me to pray that Donald Trump will be kept. We'll be delivered from Obama, Hillary Clinton, and all the evil. I'm here, Father. Use me. When I began to call people a few months ago to pray for Donald Trump, a lot of people were not too happy with me. Oh, they didn't want to support the Lord's house anymore. Most of the African tithes have stopped for over 3 months. We have received very little offering, very little tithe. A lot of the people stopped completely. Brothers and sisters, praise the Lord. Sometimes I got really worried a couple of months ago, or a month ago. I said, I'm going to have to go back to work. Praise the Lord. I'm going to just go back to work. And when I have time, I'll do the Lord's Tower. But the Lord reminded me that he had called me. And he that had called me will sustain me, will support me, and will provide. But I was worried that I would have to go back to work and just leave the preaching for another day. Praise the Lord. But the Lord reminded me that if not men supported, if God supported, he has promised me his support. And that's all I need, his word, his promise. The Father will take care of me. But I don't need to worry. Praise you, God. I have to be reminded by God of his own promise to me. Praise you, Lord. Because I forget. Sometimes you get in trouble and you forget. You see things happening, you forget. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. There were two words I gave up the Lord's Hour for next year. One, that Donald Trump will be president. And another, that I will have a daughter this year. Then I had said that, brothers and sisters. Both words are fulfilled today. Both words have come to pass today. My daughter is on her way, coming. She's in the womb, being born, growing every day. Please pray for her. Rebecca is coming. She's here already. She's growing. And the Donald Trump, hallelujah. Praise you, God, will also be president. Two words that I said, I will remind you next year that it will come to pass. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Someone had asked me in private, said, Brother Elvi, please tell me. I said, yes, my daughter and the Donald Trump will be president. I wanted to wait until next year, until she's born, because she's growing in the womb. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, God. Please pray for her. Keep her in prayer. Praise you, Lord. It is all in God's hand. Thank you, Jesus. But yes, everything, it is exactly as God has told me he would. Brothers and sisters, Thank you, Jesus. We very soon will have the land. The community will be, it's all in the working process. I don't want to talk about the land and the community that, hallelujah, is in the working process right now. Praise the Lord. But I will make a call on the Lord's Hour for everyone who will work with us in the community to start calling in, to start contacting us, who wants to work for God, who wants to help us 5,000 people or more. We are going to shelter 5,000 people with the Lord's provision. We'll have more than the money we need, more than the land we need, brothers and sisters, more than the buildings we need. Praise you, Lord. Everything will be more than enough. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, God. I didn't want to tell people anything because everything is in the hand of the Lord. It's in the process. I wasn't going to keep this quiet, but I want everyone to pray. Those that love the Lord. I believe this is my last job before we go home. Help those 5,000 people, brothers and sisters, with provision, food, clothing, whatever we can help them with. It will be a community. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We have, Jesus showed me back in Massachusetts that we will be over 30 ministers coming to do ministry with us, brothers and sisters. God willing, all this is in God's hand. He showed me back in Massachusetts. I said, Lord, when the Lord showed me this work, I said, Lord, I cannot do this on my own. I need help. I immediately told the Lord, I need help, Lord. The Lord says, the Lord showed me. He spoke to me and showed me the face of 33 ministers, women and men, that will come from the different states to help me in this work God is giving us to do, to help the 5,000 plus people. Now, what the Lord showed me the other day, literally like three times, is that there will be more than 5,000 people, but we will have enough food in storage that the extra people that we could not keep in the community, we will give them food before we send them out. I don't think that we can keep more than 5,000 people. The Lord has already showed this to me. This teared my heart in two when I saw this, because you don't want to turn people away in a situation that is coming. What Jesus showed me the other morning about the Jewish judgment that is all tied up to this, the Lord says to me was, the judgment is imminent. He used the word imminent. I'm very careful using that word imminent. But when the Lord says to me that it's imminent, the judgment is imminent, he did not tell me how soon it is. He showed me that very soon the nation will be in the middle of all this judgment, and that the judgment is imminent. Imminent is the word he used. I was sharing with a brother and sister. I said, hey, I got to pray about this before I even say it on the Lord's Hour, because the Lord showed me the judgment and told me that it's evident. The Lord knows how serious that word is, and that we have to be careful before we even use that word, because imminent is something that it will happen no matter what. There's no going back in it. And I know why he told me it's imminent, because he knew I would pray. I would try to pray it away. But he reminded me that it's imminent. It came from the Lord. And I said, oh, wow, okay. I understand that when something is imminent, cannot be prayed away. But I believe it can be pushed away by prayer. And so I immediately began to pray, to push it away in prayer, that it will be put off later. It's imminent, but I believe it can be put off for later, is what I believe. Some people may disagree with me about it. Praise the Lord, but I believe it can. I believe it can, brothers and sisters. Thank you, Lord. So pray, thank you, Jesus. All the word, as he has shown me, as he has told me, have come to pass exactly. The only thing we don't know is the day and the hour, but everything that we were going to need, he has provided. He has provided everything, brothers and sisters. We just got to make sure we are led by the Lord in every single step we take, brothers and sisters. Praise the Lord. We will have the engineer we already have the lawyer. We will have the engineer and architect and the company who will be in charge of all the building and everything. Everything will come to pass exactly as the Lord has said. It is the Lord that is in control, brothers and sisters. The mayor that was here in the city would not allow that type of project to be built in this city. God is so merciful that the mayor has been removed, and a new mayor, because of what the old mayor has done, has driven away many other companies, brothers and sisters. But you see that the hand of God, it is in all this. The old mayor has been removed, and the new mayor welcomes all these projects, brothers and sisters. The lawyer will have no problem with City Hall getting all the licensing and everything we need to build this community, because the mayor welcomed this type of project. God has done everything. And I look at this, when Moses was driven out of Egypt, running from Pharaoh, remember that before he could return, Pharaoh has to die. God will have to remove that old Pharaoh, brothers and sisters, before Moses can return. And God did it. God told Moses, Pharaoh has died. He told him to return. But Moses did not need it to be afraid. Yes, there will be a war with Pharaoh afterward, but the one that made the law for Moses to die was not there anymore, brothers and sisters. And when I came here, I came under that mayor. And my lawyer, a brother in the Lord, called the mayor to find out, and knew from the mayor that we could not build that type of project, but the mayor has been removed. God has been at work doing everything, brothers and sisters. I tell you, before I even came here, the best lawyer, over 30 years of experience lawyer, God opened the door. They contacted me in Massachusetts before I even came here. I told the people, and the lawyer's wife is a prophet. They contacted me, invited me to their office and all that. God has opened the door. It has been God, brothers and sisters, from the beginning, before I even came to Massachusetts. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It all has to do with the companies. The companies are the one that will have the architect and the engineer are the one that will make the plan, and they'll say how long it will take. We will want the project to be done ASAP, as soon as possible. But praise the Lord, the building of the project, the land and all, even all that is in God's hand. Because what the Lord has shown me, when the Lord has shown me that everything will be in place, the building will be in place and all that, the Lord gave me a sign when. And the sign is about to pass, it's about to come, close. He gave me a sign, because I always, back in Massachusetts, I remember always giving the Lord a sign. Lord, this sign, or the Lord will give me a sign. I will do this when this happens, with this. And I will give the Lord a sign to the Lord. And then the Lord would say, okay, and I will fulfill the sign. And he's given me a sign. So when the building will be in place and the land will be prepared and everything will be ready to go. Praise you, Jesus. That's why I'm asking people to pray. Because everything is coming to pass. Exactly how the Lord said it will come to pass in the timing of the Lord. Not in our timing. I've been asking the Lord to please hurry up because of the need of people, but even that has to be in the timing of the Lord, because a lot of people are not serious. A lot of people are just scared from other countries and just want to come because they're afraid. But they may not want to come to serve the Lord, to come and praise the Lord with us together in the temple, because it will be such a light church to feed all those people also. Hallelujah. It's in the state of North Carolina. And so a lot of people just want to do it because of fear, but not because they want to see God. And that's not the purpose of this project. We have talked about this. The purpose of the project is to come and serve the Lord together. It's a place of refuge, brothers and sisters. And so that's why I've been hesitant to even say it on the Lord's Tower. I've been careful not to say it, because a lot of people can misunderstand this whole plan. Thank you, Jesus. It's for the glory of God. It's in God's timing. Thank you, Jesus. We are trusting on the Lord and nobody else. It is the Lord who's bringing this to pass. Thank you, Jesus. And we just want to serve the Lord and do the will of God, brothers and sisters, nothing else. That's it. and they serve the Lord, they do the will of God. That's it. Thank you, Jesus. So pray. They are on the refuge that I've been told, the Lord has told all the ministry to build, and they're already building those too. Everything is coming to place in God's time. Here in North Carolina, in other states, God has told other people to build other refuge for many crowd of people that will come. I tell you, judgment is imminent. We need to continue to repent. We need to continue to seek the Lord. Thank you, Jesus, because judgment will come. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Here's the latest, some of the prophecy from this past week. Thank you, Lord.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, this is Reverend Mary. YouTube channel is Reverend Mary, and I would like to welcome you